So YouTube, team keep it clean. What's going on? It's Engraven here with another video. And wow, my voice is really deep right now. Not Calais Campbell deep, but it's deep because this is the first thing that I'm saying all morning. But good morning. Hope all of y'all are good. Hope everything is going good with y'all. Today the Ravens had a presser that featured John Harbaugh. And he didn't give any updates on anybody that's injured. And he said that too. He said, I don't give any definitive stuff. Nope, I'm not doing it. So he was straight up with it. And it seemed like John Harbaugh, though, he was in a really, really good mood. Like, an extra good mood. Not the normal John Harbaugh good mood, but he was in, like, an extra good mood. So, good for him. I guess practice went pretty good today. And he must be really happy getting a lot of guys back. Because the offensive line is stronger now than it's ever been. It's been Cleveland practice for the second straight day. Ronnie Stanley, of course, is back. So there, Tyree Phillips, he came back too. So maybe that's why. So I expect whenever all the receivers come back, and it's got to be really soon, I expect him to have the biggest smile on his face that we've ever seen. Well, besides the Super Bowl smile, because ain't nothing going to top that except another one. Anyway, after John Harbaugh spoke, Lamar Jackson spoke, and Jeff Zriebick, he asked him about Jeremy Fowler's comment about Lamar Jackson being figured out this year. And Lamar Jackson, he responded to it and said that he strongly doubts it. He strongly doubts it, but he said they just got to play football. He didn't get into it. He seemed like he really didn't even care about it. Because, again, like we talked about when we initially spoke on Jeremy Fowler and that comment, people been saying that from jump. They've been saying that from jump, and they always would say the same exact thing. After those first 8 games he played his rookie year, he caught the league by storm, but now teams got film on him. He's going to get figured out. Then he went on to have an MVP season. Then it's like, now teams got a whole season of film on him. Now he's going to get figured out. So it's nothing new. He was also asked about actually playing in the preseason, and he said that's up to coach. He said that's up to coach. He said he's down to play. He said he wants to play. But he said that's completely up to Harbaugh. And now with the offensive line being all the way back, everybody's back. We'll see. We'll see, because this is obviously the last preseason game. So this, if he does play, and if they do play, this will be their last like warm-up before it's go time in a couple weeks after that. Because that Monday Night Football game, it's almost here, y'all. It's almost here. So time is moving. He also talked about, I don't know who asked him the question, but they said Hot Pockets or Pizza Rolls. And he said both. But anyway, he was also asked about the preseason streak being 19-0. He said, no, don't jinx it. Why you had to say something? But don't worry, jinxes, they're not real. And he also mentioned when they brought up that about the streak, he talked about how he said they're just a competitive team. And obviously the streak started before he was on the Ravens, but he's now been a part of the streak since he's been on the Ravens too. But yeah, he just talked about how competitive they are. I loved how Tyus Bowser mentioned it yesterday in the presser. He said, as long as there's a scoreboard up there, we trying to win. We trying to win. But like I said, hopefully, what we're going to do this year, we're all going to send a message, and they obviously have to make it there initially. So, but if they do make it there, we expect them to, but they still got to put in that work to make it there. But if they make it to the playoffs, what we're going to do, we're going to convince all the Ravens, the players, the coaching staff, all of that. We're going to say, hey, all right, season's over. It's the off season now. Now, these playoff games, we're going to convince them that they're preseason games. And then we'll be guaranteed to win the Super Bowl. He was also asked about Tyler Huntley and how Tyler Huntley's been doing. And he said, hey, now y'all get to see it too, what we've been talking about. But the cat is out the bag. He said he wanted to keep it under wraps, but now the world knows and gets to see what he's capable of. And he's happy for him. He said he's super happy for Tyler Huntley. And he's glad to be on the same team with Tyler Huntley, because he said they used to battle back in high school. And he said he used to get ticked off and used to be so frustrated having to go against him, because Tyler Huntley would be making a lot of plays. But now he's glad to have him on his side. And we are too. We are too. Because Tyler Huntley, again, perfect backup for Lamar Jackson. Perfect backup because he, maybe not at the level Lamar does it at, but he can still keep this thing moving. So it's, I can't wait till the season starts, man. And he was, of course, also asked about the chemistry with the guys who have been out, like all of his receivers, all of them have been out. Like right now, Sammy Watkins, Hollywood, Boykin, and even Prochet was out today. And of course, Bateman, he's been out, but all of his top receivers are out, every last one. So right now, it's like that Devin Duvernay is like that Will Smith gif. When he's at the house all alone, everybody done moved out all this stuff. Devin Duvernay just sitting around just like that. Oh, and then Tylan Wallace too. So that was all Lamar said. So this was a pretty short presser. They just ready to get back to business, man. You could tell. They tired of these pressers. They just ready to be speaking on the regular season. And we are almost there. We're very, very close. But Ronnie Stanley, he also spoke to the media today. And he was, of course, asked about the injury. And if he had time to reflect on the timing of everything. Because he had just got his deal. He had just gotten paid. And then, boom, he got hurt and he was out for the year. And he said, yeah, I definitely had a lot of time to reflect on it because he was out. And he was out for a long time. But he said that it used to be very frustrating for him and tough for him to just even watch football because he wasn't able to be out there with his guys. He wasn't able to be out there playing and whatnot. And it was just, it was frustrating. So he said he did a lot of playing with his dogs. He did a lot of playing video games. He said he's addicted to, I think he said Apex Legends right now. But he's just really glad to be back. And we're glad to have him back, especially after last year. Because last year, it was rough enough with Ronnie Stanley. But then once he went out, it continued being even rougher. And I think a huge part of that, I know a huge part of that was Marshawnda being gone. So that loss was Marshawnda, them losing Marshawnda, him retiring. That was huge, man. He talked about how the injury gave him a newfound appreciation for the game of football itself. And he talked about somebody who has always had the appreciation for the game of football, who he's watched ever since he's come in, that being Lamar Jackson. Somebody asked about what has Lamar Jackson improved on. And he said just his game. He said whether it's his arm angles or his throwing motion, his footwork. He said that Lamar Jackson, his approach to the game, he spoke about how, and I'm paraphrasing, this weren't his words exactly, but what he was saying was that with Lamar Jackson, a lot of people, Lamar takes the game a lot more serious than people feel. And his approach to his work ethic is a lot more serious than a lot of people think it is. So he said that Lamar Jackson is the same Lamar Jackson that he was, and he's always trying to get better. And we can see that. We see that from during the games and stuff. We see how when things don't go right, he gets so frustrated. Frustrated at big stuff that doesn't go right, but also frustrated at little stuff that doesn't go right. Because if you have a bunch of little things that aren't going right, then, yeah, that's going to equate to something big going down in a negative way. So it was just nice to hear from both of those guys. Two first-round draft picks, two huge pieces for the Ravens. And really everybody is a big piece because it's a team game. It takes everybody. So we'll see how this thing goes, man. We'll see how it goes. I don't know, man. I told y'all with the whole preseason and the starters playing, I just throw my hands up in the air with it because I don't know what to expect. I don't know who to expect to play because after week two in that preseason game, I thought we were going to see Tyler Huntley. And then in the second half, I thought we were going to see Kenji, but it was all the Tyler Huntley show. Kenji just came in and do a couple of handoffs and some kneel downs, and that was it. So we'll see how this thing goes, man. But anyway, love y'all. I appreciate y'all. Hope y'all have a great, great Tuesday. And dang, just like Ronnie Stanley was for a long time, but he's not anymore, we out.